So welcome everyone to the last talk of today. I'm happy to announce Leonardo Lamy, who is here to present the G3W suit, which is, from what I heard, a framework, a modular framework to work with QGIS projects. I hope you will enjoy this last bit of presentations before going on to the icebreaker and having some fun.
Thank you. Hello everyone. My name is Leonardo Lamy. I'm a founding member of G3W company, and in this presentation I will talk about G3W-SUITE framework, an application dedicated to the publication and management of the QGIS project as WebGIS services. Unfortunately, my partner, Bart Lorenzetti, that is the responsible for development, could not come here because of an accident, and not serious, unfortunately. So therefore, I am sorry if I made not able to reply to the more technical questions of your interest. In any case, you can send a mail to Lorenzetti that will reply quickly. Before start, I make a simple short brief about G3W. It is a small Italian information technology company. It was born in 2009, and this is the currently team. About the history of G3W-SUITE, we can say that the object were using QGIS project as a basis for defining the contents of WebGIS services, organize these services in hierarchical organized containers. So the idea of cartographic and macro groups and cartographic groups, being able to define policies for access and management of individual web services, and finally the possibility to activate dedicated module or editing function in a profiled way. The result of our work is an open source application under MPL licensing available on GitHub repository, G3W-SUITE. Here, G3W-SUITE is a modular client server application consisting of two main components: G3W-Admin, the administration component, and G3W-Client, a cartographic client for consultation and interaction with OGC services. There are also two optional modules: a front-end geographic portal for searching and accessing to WebGIS services in a profiled way, and a caching module powered by Telestash. Here you can see the technological stack of the application. PostgreSQL or SQLite is used for the management of the suite data, while cartographic data can be stored in PostGIS, SpatialLite, or file system. QGIS server is used clearly as OGC services server. G3W-Admin is the core module. It is developed in Python using Django, and it allows the management of user, project, and other settings. And it functions as an API REST server for communication with the client. To ensure the control of access to OGC services, it acts as a proxy. Finally, we have G3W-Client that is developed with JavaScript open layers, and it is based on a reactive technology by Vue.js. Here you can see a simple standard workflow. User upload the QGIS project, set ACL and other option through the G3W-admin GUI. G3W-admin stores in DB info about the project, layers, settings, and so on. On Bootstrap, G3W-client calls init API, and G3W-admin sends project stored data and get as information data through a get project setting to QGIS server. After Bootstrap, G3W-admin works as a proxy for OGC services request. Now I'll show you in more detail the features of the main components of the application. G3W-admin is a graphical user interface for dynamic definition parameters for G3W-client API REST configuration. And through this component, the administrator user is completely independent in the publishing and managing WebG services under all the aspects. Here you can see the administration interface. Here the administrator user can create thematic and cartographic groups and macro groups. You can create single users and user groups that can be associated to different roles with the different powers: administrator, manager, viewer, and editor. Clearly, you can publish your QGIS project, and you can manage published WebGIS services. Finally, you can activate specific functional modules and define, assign them to single WebGIS or single user. Clearly, many aspects of WebGIS are inherited directly from a QGIS project. Like the title of the project that become the title of WebGIS service, general settings of the service, and the feature of single layer, for example, activation scale, display order, and the status and the activation status, published attribute fields, and so on. The WMS service setting, publish extension, SR restriction, and so on. Double FS service settings of the individual layers, and they are used to permit the bounding box and the polygon query. Print layouts available, and therefore the system inherits for every layer the published attribute fields, the attribute form structure, and the editing widget associated with single attribute fields. For each layer, you can inherit it also one-to-one and one-to-n relation info. Here, you can see the administration interface, because once a QGIS project is published, for each layer, it's possible to set different function and, for example, you can create search tools that are inheritable from the same layer if it is present in other projects. You can enable, disable double MS legend. You can allow layer download in shapefile format. And you can manage cache single layer tiling by tiles cache. You can also enable editing online and defining editing geographical constraints for each user enabled to edit. Clearly, all the result of all these settings are visible on the cartographic client. G3W-client is based on a modular approach. It allows have an interface that adapts to the management of the currently available models and the future ones. Here you can see the main features of the client. You can clearly browse the interactive cartography, set the map control available, use various methods of interrogation, puntual, bounding box, polygon. You can change WebGIS services, maintaining extension and scale. You can print the map using the layouts defined in the QGIS project. You can consult simple metadata inherited from general capabilities. And you can use search tools created in G3W-Admin. And you can consult attribute using the form that you defined in a QGIS project. Inside this form, you can consult multimedia links and display image preview. Finally, you can consult also one-to-one and one-to-n relation data, ever defined at the QGIS project level. You can also consult the attribute table with a filter system and a pagination system. Sorry. Okay, now I will show a short video about publication system. In the example, the QGIS project is dedicated to the management of public buildings and of the related maintenance operation. Okay. We have different, in the project, we have different type of layers, a geographical, alphanumeric table, WMS. For the main layer, public buildings, I set up an attribute form, you see, several editing widgets for the various fields, and a one-to-n relation with the operation table. I also set up two print layouts, and in the project properties menu, I define a title, the list of queryable layers, the relation, and the general capabilities of the project. Now, if we access to G3W-Admin as an administrator user, we choose a cartographic group to publish the QGIS project, QGIS project, and with a dedicated form, we can simply upload the QGIS project, set base layers, set ACL settings, defining manager and viewer of the projects, single user or a user group. We can set a short description of the services, upload the logo, and we can define the query control modes for the different query types, single or multiply. Then we save. Before see the result, we can set other aspects refer to, wait a moment, the list. Here we have the list of the layers of the project, and we can, for each layer, set some specific function. For example, disable WMS legend, enable download shape file, and create a search tool through this form. In this form, you can choose fields, methods for entering value, aliases, and a comparison operator. Okay, we active the search tool, and we see the result on the cartographic client. We can see the talk structured as in the QGIS project, base layer, legend, simple metadata about general, spatial, and single metadata layers. We can print the map with available layouts. very fast because. And we can use the search tools created before in G3W-Admin. If we query the public buildings layer, we see the attribute in the form with the tab groups and so on, and we can see the list of the maintenance operated related by one-to-one relation. I make a little focus on editing online module. It works directly on DB by custom API. You can set permission at the level of single layer. There is the possibility to use multi-user editing through a feature lock system that is applied to the features that are visible in the canvas when the edit starts. You can enable snap function, and we can set geographical constraints based on other layers in the project, and settable for individual or group users. As for the geometry editing, it's possible to edit point, line, polygons, create, move, vertex edit, delete. We can enable intralayer snap and set a geographical constraint. As for the attributes data, we can use attribute form structure defined in the QGIS project, use editing widget associated to single fields, and edit the attribute data connected by one-to-one or one-to-n relation. Another short video, where in the previous WebGIS service, we are going to activate the editing function on the layer of public buildings and on the related table. You can see you can set a scale activation scale and set up user single or user group enabled to edit. You can also activate a geographic constraint relative in the example to the blue border polygons. And in this example, we set for the viewer one the possibility to edit only features within a polygon with the ID equals one. So if we access to the WebGIS as viewer one, this time from the geographical portal, and we activate the editing. Okay. We can see that only the buildings inside the polygon number one are enabled to edit. We can create a new feature using snap. And we can compile the attribute using form and editing widget. Combo box, relation widget, calendar, multimedia file upload. Simple value, number value or text, checkbox, and so on. We can also edit the relating maintenance operation. Also, in this case, using form and editing widget. Okay. Now, we save all. And now, if we query The new feature, we can see the output in the form. We can display image preview, access to multimedia file, and consult the list of maintenance operation. Okay, just here the list, the mainly study cases with example of Italian administration, national park, all multi-utility company that used G3W-SUITE. And this is the last slide, the future developments. Python migration from 2 to 3 within the end of the year, use of QGIS 3 API next year, the release of editing module that you see in the next few weeks, implementation of geographic analysis modules via double PS service, and the release of CS double service by integrating PyCSV. So it's all. Thanks to all of you.
Thank you very much. Looks like a quite nicely done project, very promising, I'm sure. We'll have some questions here too.
Hi. That seems to be quite a feat to realize such a stuff. I had just a question. If I'm modifying my QGIS project, how can I put that modification on the version which is already done online?
If you modify your QGIS project, you have to re-upload the project in the G3 double admin interface. This is because we think that before to replace the new WebGIS service, the user have to be certain of their work. It's not directly.
Thank you very much for using QGIS server in such a powerful use case. In your opinion, you're relying on QGIS server, which has been totally refactored and rewritten. What could we improve in the QGIS server part for the future so that you can go further?
We have to see what the refactoring of QGIS server in the new function of
I was thinking of improving the OGC compliancy, for instance, or adding the WFS3 maybe in the future.
Yeah, we follow the now you are we are on version 3.4 about QGIS server. And in the future, we can see, we have to see what the new improvement in the new version.
Thank you very much for the presentation. So my question is, if I would like to integrate the mobile application to the whole entire architecture for the data collection in the field, so what is your recommendation? It's going to be the Q field, the mobile application for the data collection in the field. Do you have any recommendation? Open source based the mobile application.
Sorry?
For
mobile.
Yeah, sorry. Sorry. The application is quite available also on mobile, not smartphone, but
tablet
or we have no app in program to deploy the app like Field.
It's only web, right? I mean, internet. So it doesn't support offline capability.
It does?
Yeah, offline.
Yeah,
I mean,
no.
Only web.
It doesn't work offline.
Okay.
Only if you are connected.
Okay, thank you very much.
So I think we can take two more questions. Andreas first, and then maybe Gavin.
Thank you for the presentation. And I have a question. When the user is editing the data, how do you get that data back into the database? Are you using WFST or your own API? Or are you relying on QGIS server for storing it back? Or what mechanism are you using for editing the data?
When you send the data back to the server to store it in the database, what protocol are you using there? Is it WFST?
Sorry, I cannot reply to this question, but if you are interested, you can send a mail.
So one last question here, I think.
Thanks. I think I can maybe help answer that one. You said that editing happens through a custom API directly on the database, not through WFST. That's just to help answer that question. But my question is, how do you define Postgres connections? If you're setting up a project in your office and the QGIS server is running on a Postgres database in the cloud, how do you ensure that the databases are synchronized, and how do you define the connections? Using normal connection strings or services, so that when you upload your project, it will just work?
So, well, if the data are on DB, there are no problem because the application can communicate with the DB, also if it is another server. About file system data, you can upload through G3W-Admin component the data on the server. I don't show this part of the application, but there is a component that permits that.
So since it's the last session, I think we have time for
one
really last
short
question.
Sorry, I didn't find a license about the project. It's open source, okay. Which license does it use?
MPL.
MPL.
Okay.